Good morning students, how are you? I hope you have completed your first unit test successfully, isn't it? Right, let we start this class with 31-7-2020 assignment answers. So I gave the three problems, right? First one, the probability that a girl preparing for competitive examination will get a state government service is 0.12. The probability that she will get a central government job is 0.25. And the probability that she will get both 0.07. Find the probability that she will get at least one of the jobs. Second division, she will get only one of the two jobs. So I ask you to do the sum by reference of exercise 12.2, sixth problem. Have you remember? So with the reference of exercise 12.2, sixth problem, we can solve the assignment problem. Let me see the answer for that. So let A be the event of getting state government service. Let B be the event of getting central government job. Right? So probability of getting state government service is 0.12. Probability of getting central government job is 0.25. So we can write P of A is equal to 0.12 and P of B is equal to 0.25. And the probability that she will get both is 0.07. So probability of A intersection B is 0.07. So first division, probability that at least one of the job, probability of getting at least one of the job, that is A or B, therefore probability of A union B, that means you can apply the addition theorem on probability. So probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B, so substitute the values. So probability of A is 0.12 plus probability of B is 0.25 minus probability of A intersection B is 0.07. So when you add these two, you'll get 0.37 minus 0.07. So subtract, you'll get the answer as 0.30, that is 0.3. So probability of getting at least one of the jobs is 0.3. So second division, probability of getting only one of the two jobs. That means that is only A or only B. So R means you can put addition. So probability of only A or plus probability of only B. So only A means the notation is A intersection B bar. Only B means the notation is A bar intersection B. So we have the formula. Probability of A intersection B bar means probability of A minus probability of A intersection B. Similarly, probability of A bar intersection B na probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. So substitute the values. So probability of A 0.12 minus, this is 0.07, plus probability of B is 0.25 minus A intersection B. Probability of A intersection B is 0.07. Right? So when you add these two, 0.1, sorry, when you simplify 0.12 minus 0.07, you'll get 0.05 plus 0.25 minus 0.07 is 0.18. So when you add, you'll get the answer as 0.23. So probability of getting only one of the two jobs is 0.23. So second sum, a die is rolled if it shows an odd number, then find the probability of getting 5. So a die is rolled if it shows an odd number. So we fix the conditions on the sample space itself. So it always shows the odd number. Odd number means 1, 3, 5. Right? So n of s is equal to 3. So let A be the, find the probability of getting 5. So let A be the event of getting 5. So A is equal to 5 alone. Right? So n of A is equal to 1. Therefore P of A is equal to n of A by n of S. So it is equal to 1 divided by 3. So third sum, if A and B are independent, then prove that A bar and B are also independent. So A and B are independent means we know the result. Probability of A intersection B is equal to P of A into P of B. So what you have to prove? A bar and B are also independent. That means we have to prove that probability of A bar intersection B is equal to P of A bar into P of B. So we can consider the left hand side, probability of A bar intersection B. We know the formula for that. Probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. So it is equal to P of B minus, we can write this as P of A into P of B. So you can take P of B outside. So remaining 1 minus P of A. So which is equal to P of B into this is P of A bar. So we have proved that probability of A bar intersection B is probability of A bar into probability of B. So which is our right hand side. So hence proved. So assignment problems over ma. So already in the last class, exercise 12.3, first two problems we have completed. So in the next video, you can go for the third problem. Thank you.